Okay, let's consider another problem. There's a 10th problem in your workbook, same sections of solids. So that is a square prism of base height 30 mm and height 75 mm rests on HP with its base such that the rectangular faces are equally inclined to VP. It is cut by a plane perpendicular to VP and inclined at 60 degrees to HP, meeting the axis 15 mm from the top face. Draw its front view, sectional top view and true shape of the section. So this is a question. So we will look into it. How will we draw this? As you know, this is a prism. First you have to draw the symbol position. So you have to draw the symbol position of the square prism of side 30 and height 75 mm. So first you draw the XY line. Draw an XY line. Since the square prism is equally inclined to VP, here also you have to draw it 45 degree. So 45 degree and the side of base is 30 mm. So side of base is 30 mm. Now turn the line. This is 30 mm. See, you just name it A, B, C, D. This is a top, A, B, C, D is a top face, bottom face, say P, Q, R, S. Now you just draw the front view. Height is 75 mm. Project. This longer edge you have to mark. After this you have to name it properly. So you know the top face is ABCD. So this is A dash. Here it is D dash, B dash. This is C dash. And this is P dash, S dash, Q dash, and R dash. Now you know how to draw the section plane. It is clearly stated that the section plane is inclined to HP at an angle of 60 degrees. And which passes through at a point 15 mm from the top face. So that not through the midpoint. In this case it is not through the midpoint. It states that from the top face you just take 15 mm on the axis. Since this is the axis, center you have to mark O bracket P. This is O dash, P dash is a center. Axis. Now from the top face on the axis, since this is also the axis, just mark 15 mm. At that point, just draw a 60 degree line. So place protractor at that point, 60 degree line. Now this is the section plane. See, this is the section plane. Here also you can do these kinds of things. VT. Now putting the names, cutting point names. You see, this is your 1', 1', cutting at a line AP. You see, as you know, this square prism goes like this. This is a square prism. Here our name, we have named A, B, C, P. This is P, Q, R, S. So you should be careful while getting the cutting points. This 1', 1' is on AP. 1' is on AP. That means here you get 1' here. This is a point 1'. Now where you get point 2'. This is point 2'. 2' is on, if you are looking from this direction, say 2' is on PS. So you will get 2' somewhere here. Suppose you get 2' here. So this is the point 2. This is point 2. And where you will get point 3. 3, here it is a 3. 3 means it is on the top face. BC. Here I will get point 3. Not anywhere else. So this point means this is actually the square top face. On that top face, the top face edge DC is having the cutting point 3', and behind that DC we have another line. This is BC. Here it is BC. That for BC you have to give name 4'. So here it is 4'. Now where will you get this next point 5'? Behind BQ. This is the DS is a front line, your front long edge. Behind that DS another line BQ, that is having a cutting point 5. So you will get 5 here somewhere. Here I think, suppose here. So while joining these points, say you are cutting the section point, this point, this will be your 5. This will be good. You are cutting section, you will get section like this. So I will draw it here. Anyway, I will draw it here. So, but you should be careful while giving the names on all those points. Now, in top view, where you mark the sectional points, this one, since this AP is a vertical line, when you cut a vertical line, you just look the top view, this get AP, you know, the AP and 1' will be on same point. Since this is a vertical line, if you have the top view, if you look into look from this direction, if you take the top view from this direction, you see A1P are on the same line. So you will have a point 1, you have point 1 here on AP, since it is a vertical line. So where will you get this point 2? This will be your point 2, since this DS is a vertical line. This DS and 2 is on a same vertical line, so you get 2 here. Then to project this 3 and 4, we can get it from the front view. You just simply project this point from here. This you will get two cutting points. This will be 3 and this will be 4. So 3 on say DC and 4 on BC. This is a DC, here it is DC. This DC you got 3 and top face BC you got 4. While joining all these points, so you have 5 here also. 5 is on BQ. BQ you have 5. So join all these points. So you have a section like this. So this is the sectional view in top view. This is a section in top view. This is an actual section. While projecting in top view, you will get it like this. If you want to draw the true shape, there is any method you can choose, but I will go for an auxiliary plane method. Auxiliary plane method, how? Just draw a parallel line. Just draw a parallel line to the section plane. Parallel line to the section plane. It should be perfectly parallel. See. And put a name as x0, y0. And normally this auxiliary line should not intersect the your views, front view. So that you just keep a distance from the front view to draw this x0, y0. Now, as you know, draw perpendicular projectors from each cutting points. Perpendicular projectors. So you can use protractor here to draw the perpendicular projectors. This is the projector for 2 and 5. You have here. Now to take the distance, the same method you can use from XY line to 1 from top view. You can take this distance from XY line to 1 of the top view. So the auxiliary plane, this mark here, so this is your point 1. This is the point 1. Now L you get 2 and 5 from XY line. Take this 2, mark here. This is 2. What about 5? This is 5. So you can write it down. Since this is a 2, this point is 5. About 4 and 3, to carefully take distance from XY line, not anywhere else. This is 3, mark it here. Take 4, mark it here. So you have 3 here and 4 here. Now you just simply join all these points. You will have the true shape. You see, just hatch it. Simply hatch it. You can keep the distance between hatch lines as 2 to 3 mm. So normally need not be 45 here. How will you take the inclination of this hatch line? You can assume a symmetry line to this true shape. To that line you can take 45 degree. not necessary 45 degree to the xy line here. You cannot take 45 degree with xy line on here, this portion. For that, what you have to do is just assume a symmetry line. To that line, take a 45 degree. For any section, you can mark like that also, no problem. What ought to be? For any section, you can mark, you can hatch it 45 degree to this symmetry line. Now, this is a projection of, section of a prism. One important point you have to remember when doing problems of pyramids and prism. See, in pyramids, is also a vertical line. Here it is also a vertical line, but the section point in top view I get it here. Since this is a slant edge, I am having a point here. But what is at this in this case here? You see, because of this slant edge, we have a point here. In this case, you see, it's a vertical line. These are the vertical lines. In vertical lines, you have points on the top view. A, P, 1 will be on same point. That should be taken care of. Okay, thank you.